Welcome back to Outdoors with Larry Ray on ESPN 790 AM. Brought to you proudly by Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency, Barton Power Sports, Sportsman's Warehouse, and Best Care Home Services.
And welcome back to Outdoors with Larry Ray, the special edition of Open Mic Saturday, our foul show.
Yeah, well,
it's, the way we talk, it sounds like very
foul. Yeah, we're both foul.
You know, everything, but in fact, speaking of Mighty Duck Hunters.
I think we got him on the line.
I believe he's on the line right now. You with us, Larry?
Yeah, I'm here, guys. It took us a little extra. Frank is still out there making sure the decoys are right, but we were hoping his son and grandson would be able to hunt with us, but they couldn't come, so it's me and Frank and Delta. And Delta, of course, is his dog, which is the most important of everything. We've got a we don't have a favorable wind. You know, it's me again. You know, I mean, if it's going to be a thunderstorm or something. I get in the duck blind, and the first thing he says, well, the wind's not really good. And so I say, well, okay, and it's us. But wonderful morning. Golly, it's a great morning. Other than that wind that we were hoping it would not be and you know that, Dave, as well. The wind plays a real important part in this
thing. Oh, yeah, real important.
And when it comes up out of that south, the way I understand, you know, I've always thought fishing's the least when it comes out of the east. But and Jeff Martin's coming on just a few minutes from the Taj Mahal. But we are in Lansing Bottoms, Frank and myself, and I've got my new banded waders on, and believe me, I needed them because we do have water, and it's a little mucky, and I've aged since last year. I don't have the same. I look like Fred Astaire trying to get into the blind. You know, we got. You could hear. I don't know if you could hear Frank going by.
Yeah, I hear.
One of his wonderful ATV guys that you can buy over at any of the Barton Power Sports, and he's got Delta sitting with him. But the sun is just now coming up. We haven't had any ducks yet. I don't know if till we get settled here, but it was good to hear Jay on before me. You folks don't remember. Don't forget. Don't remember. That's my problem. I don't remember. But I'm the healthy one sitting out here with no coughing and sneezing like Dave is. And I appreciate Dave Gabbert sitting in on this special. Now you got me calling.
Yeah, now.
Special Saturday morning. Yeah, this is foul day. And I appreciate Dave coming in. And Frank will be our co-host. And we'll be talking to Frank a little bit later, Dave, about his family and how they've it's really interesting how they got into duck hunting. And we're in a nice blind, could shoot, I'd say, six easily, not anything like the Taj Mahal. And there went Delta by. She just stepped on my toe. And there she goes again and stepped on my toe. And then she is shaking off all the water right on me.
What color is she?
She is a chocolate. She is chocolate brown. Have y'all got Jeff on the line yet? Have you?
I think he's on. You with us, Jeff?
Yeah, I'm with you, Dave.
Okay. So
hey, Jeff.
We got dueling ducks.
Hey, Larry.
Yeah, we're over here in Lansing Bottoms in East Arkansas. Flooded field. And we haven't had anything yet. I don't know. We were talking about the wind, Jeff. I don't know. It's a little bit more south wind than we were expecting. A little bit of ice. I don't know what y'all had up at Hall's. At the Taj Mahal, but we've got a little south wind that concerns Frank. But when I've got my own personal guide and personal dog, it's just me. So it's good, Jeff. I haven't found the kitchen here yet, so I'm looking for it in the den. So this is.
I'm back here eating a sausage and biscuit right now.
Well, we've already had that at Crawford's.
The eggs, so gravy, and hash browns.
Oh, that's enough, Jeff. That's enough. Okay, guys, here comes Frank. Bless his heart.
Well, the most important question I want to ask you.
Yes.
Did your waders leak?
These waders are wonderful. They're wonderful. It's a little sticky, you know, as far as getting in and out, and I'm a little cranky. And Frank's he's not only the guide, he's everything here. So. He's getting set up, but we'll talk to y'all a little bit later. We'll get set up here, and we'll talk later. I want Frank to come on the line. So, y'all, thanks for filling in, and we are at Lansing Bottoms. not far from Crawfordsville. I met Frank at, we were here in 15 minutes now. Frank is worn out and burned down. Delta's ready for action, so we'll talk to you later. Talk to you, Jeff. Bye-bye.
Hey, okay, what do we got at Hall's this morning, Jeff?
Hang on a second, Dave.
That duck sound like...
Kill that duck!
All right.
All right, I'm with you. I'm sorry for the interruption.
Oh, that was great.
Yeah, it's
But we got like we're gonna have clear skies and a good stout south wind is what we like up here. We saw a lot of high ducks yesterday, just no working ducks, and so hopefully today will be a little better.
Yeah. Oh, are we working two dogs a day again?
Yes, we got Fly, a 4-year-old black male, and then Rain, a 2-year-old black female.
Yeah, I wish people could see Rain.
Oh, dog.
Yeah, you talk about dogs. She's the only retriever I know. She stays wound tight. She will run, you know, out there to get them, you know, loping. But most dogs, when they pick ducks up, they just kind of walk back. She does. She runs back.
Runs back, so.
She's like Michael Phelps in a pool.
That's right. And so everything, but she'll let you know.
She stuck her head in the water.
Where you going?
She stuck her head under the water to get that one.
Yeah, I see. And I watched her the other day working a duck, trying to find one dove on her, and she just stuck that head under the water.
They're having just as much fun as the
hunters.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everything, but of course, talking to Jeff Martin. Jeff, you know, for y'all, maybe our listeners don't know, Jeff's our area manager up at Realfoot, WMA. He's got Black Bayou Refuge. What kind of ducks are you holding at Black Bayou right now?
We're holding around 20,000, which is not a great number for this time of year in West Tennessee, but we're under extremely dry conditions. Mississippi River were very low, and other than the refuges and the pumped up hunting clubs, there's very little water in West Tennessee to make these ducks move up and down these river systems.
I was discussing that yesterday with a gentleman, you know, since Arkansas's just opening back up, you know, this past week, of course, them ducks can fly across the river, which is not that far.
No.
Sitting in Arkansas, so they're not being shot at. But hopefully today, once Arkansas gets geared back up and they start shooting ducks, these ducks are going to move back, to the Tennessee side.
But the long-range forecast showing that we'll probably be wetter than normal for this time, and I think that's what it'll take to turn a duck season on. A lot of time left. We're still early in the game.
You probably like me, you know, a long time, you know, duck hunters, they talk about the length of days. You know, when it all boils down, it's just the give us January, you know. Anything above that is just kind of a blessing. But
that's right.
January 1 on to the close, that's when it really gets going.
But we're going to have a good time, and we're going to eat good, and I tell Larry my waders don't leak either. I wear Drakes.
Okay. Well, we sure appreciate you talking with us this morning. Tell everybody hello up there. I'm pretty sure we'll be seeing you next week sometime.
All right, Dave. Y'all have a good day.
Okay.
Take care.
Bye.
Jeff Martin calling in from our blind up there.
Them guys do a great job managing those refuges.
And it's been, I want to say we've had that lease for 25 years. And it's really changed, you know, just back the way the surrounding area, you know, has been, the development and stuff. But
yeah, Hall's is growing.
Everything, but we're fortunate because the farmer we lease from, he does pump, you know, keeps our field pumped up and everything. So, and being exceptionally dry and You know, we need it. And but even though I can tell that you'd be surprised how much water will evaporate.
Oh, yeah.
You know, out of the field.
Especially when the wind's blowing and stuff like that.
And because we're only talking about knee-deep water.
Right.
You know.
Not a lot.
That we pump up. And we're fortunate enough over the years we have invested in. You know, we've got the ice eaters that will keep the hole open. You know, when it starts freezing. In fact, when it was a few days ago when the temperatures really got below freezing and a lot of these little pockets started freezing up. And we can keep our hole open. You know, we usually will kill ducks.
Right.
You know. And a lot of times people don't understand about ducks. And they're sitting out there in an area, you know, on a refuge and stuff. Those ducks won't get up and leave that water till they know that water's not going to freeze behind them.
Yeah.
You know, so they can return to it. So it's kind of unique way animal behavior. You know, will affect your seasons and stuff. So, but
there's so many different ducks. That's what's so interesting about duck hunting. So many different ducks.
And what's strange, you know, in the bag limit and stuff, you know, the bag can only include one pintail this year. And it's amazing on how many pintails we're seeing. You know, so it's just one of those strange
things.
See,
that's what the people don't understand. Well, some people don't understand. They set limits like that to preserve the wildlife.
Right. And but like Jeff said, that we still got a lot of duck season to go.
Yeah.
And so if you got a blind that's high and dry, well, just wait. Maybe you'll get some rain.
It's supposed to rain tomorrow.
Get a little water.
I don't know how much, but it's supposed to rain.
But it will be, it will be a pretty good season.
Yeah, so. I remember a couple of years, it got really good weather after the season was over. The cold weather up north pushed them down, and of course, by that time, duck season was over.
Yeah, a lot of people don't understand. They say, well, why can't we still hunt them in February? But that's set by the feds. And I hear music.
Yep.
And I see Stuart.
That time again.
Okay, get up, take a break, come back and join us again for another segment of the award-winning Outdoors with Larry Ray.